Yeah, we're good now, I think, right? I don't need to hear that, because these speakers are right here. So I'm good. Over on this side? The problem is the spot is over there. They can move the spot around? No, because we're going into an overflow room. I hear it from the overflow room. Sure. We have a total lunar eclipse tonight. But given how many of you were all... I don't think any of you all are watching this eclipse. But it is tonight. And it's just really cool. So the moon, as it orbits the sun, the sun is always casting an Earth shadow into space. Always casting an Earth shadow. And so the moon in its orbit occasionally passes into our shadow. That's all. That's what's going on here. So this eclipse is happening at the moon, not on Earth. So anyone who can see the moon while this is happening can see the eclipse. The entire half of the Earth that faces the moon during the eclipse sees this eclipse, and it's happening tonight. Tonight, just after midnight. And so, like I said, you're not gonna be able to see it. But I noticed a few interesting things that concerned me. So Earth's shadow is in space, and the moon goes into the shadow. The sunlight is coming from behind me, and it can't get through the Earth, but our atmosphere, some sunlight gets through the atmosphere and disperses, casting some sunlight deep into the shadow. Depending on how much dust and pollution is in the atmosphere, the sunlight that makes it through will be deep red, just like a sunset. So you have deep red light getting inside Earth's shadow. So there's the moon wanting to disappear, and it carries this deep red hue. Now I would have called it, I've seen this hue before, it's beautiful. It's like the color of rose petals. But to some people, it's the color of blood. And they named it that. So tonight, there are people calling tonight's moon the blood moon. Now, here's what happens, okay? You have a blood moon, but what happens? An eclipse, good. Thank you. That was good. So we have a blood moon. Here's the problem, some people take this literally. Okay? Not people who know how to think. Okay? Just saying. This is just a word. Blood. Blood is red. Apples are red. Rose petals are red. Okay? So, blood moon, lunar eclipse, Pastor John Hagee, to talk about the four blood moons. Well, he is sure that this is a sign of the apocalypse. Because of the word blood. Now, okay, he can think whatever he wants, right? This is a free country, and we have religious freedom. Think whatever you want. In fact, it's reported in Christian Today. I don't have an issue if he thinks this lunar eclipse that happens every couple of years is a sign from God that the world is going to end. Fine. Cornerstone Church in San Antonio, Texas. I don't have a problem with that. If he wants to give speeches on his four blood moons, okay? If that's the guy, okay? Fine. I don't have an issue with that. Until USA Today. Does Tuesday's blood eclipse signal the end of times? What the hell am I reporting? Woo! blood. This is the sun, okay? That's the sun.
Just a little bit.
The world needs help. There's a Bible passage that says, you know, the moon turns blood, and I mean, bad stuff in the apocalypse, right? If you believe all that, then I guess these are signs to you. But any person who ever said the world is going to end reading their scripture, they always said it's going to end like soon or in their lifetime. They never said the world is going to end in 1,000 years. That doesn't work because you don't get followers that way. People just take their time. There's got to be some urgency to what you're saying, like tonight. This has nothing to do with anything. We are in Louisiana. I just thought I would alert you in case you had missed this news article. Bible that was proposed here. It's the King James translation of the Bible. And that's not even Catholic, okay? They're much stronger Catholic. If you're going to do this, then take a look at what Bible people are using in your state. It's not the King James. It's the Catholic influence in Louisiana is strong. The Catholic influence is strong. So if you're going to pick a Bible of the culture, you would pick one that the Catholics use and not the one the Protestants use. If you're going to go there. So just watch that space. We'll see what happens. A few months ago, we had the harvest moon. Well, since we're on the topic of moon, all the moons of the year have names, all the full moons. I don't know if you knew that. So the harvest moon, people write songs about it and everything. It's not brighter, it's not bigger. It's just another full moon that happens near harvest time, okay? So I got that. Here's some other, the snow moon, the wolf moon, the hunger moon, the thunder moon, you know? Frosty moon, hunter flock. We got moon names. Do you know in June, the full moon, goes very low in the sky, doesn't go very high, and it goes so low it takes on some of the colors that a sunset takes on. Moonlight is just sunlight reflected, okay? So, if it's low in the sky, it's going to start turning amber just the way the sun does as it gets lower in the sky. So the full moon has a very low trajectory in June, and so the full moon taking on that amber color is known to many as the honeymoon. That's how you got a honeymoon. You ever wonder why it was called a honeymoon? That's why. Got a honey color. Now I just wonder, suppose, you know, the month for people to get married were something else. Sap moon. Yeah. Let's call a sap moon together. You know, I don't know what way. Glad it turned out to be the honeymoon. Now the harvest moon, remind you, is a full moon. But now we have an article saying, how to see the full moon. It's a full moon. Do you need help finding the full moon in the sky? Now the moon has an orbit around the Earth that's elliptical. Sometimes it's closer to Earth, sometimes it's farther. We got that. And it can have a phase at any one of those points in its orbit. It could be full moon when it's close or full moon when it's far. A couple of years ago, people decided to say, when the moon is full and the moon is close, let's call it a super moon. So now we have Now, what I have to contend with is the supermoon, all right? Supermoon, biggest full moon in 18 years.
Oh, wow.
When you see titles like this and they don't say how much bigger, okay, which way is California from here? We have agreement here. That's very good. Okay. Sometimes, you know, I don't know people. All right, that's California? Okay.
That's west.
This would be like saying that's much, right?
Bigger.
I've never been this close to California before. I've only ever been this. Celebrate my proximity. That supermoon? Let's take a look at how big the full moon was a month earlier. There it is. Okay. May, June. But no one thinks to look at the moon until it's advertised. Everybody goes, oh, look how big that moon is. Just pay attention to the sky. Pay attention. Now, I like pizza, so I just want to give an example here. Okay? A small moon, we're a 7-inch pizza. Average moon is a 7.5-inch pizza. A large moon is an 8-inch pizza. And that super moon is an 8.01-inch pizza. Okay?